What's up, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy Frankie Hard Work with another video, and this video I'm about to play is a video that I made when this Tekashi situation first happened. This video I'm gonna play for you is early in my YouTube career. This video was from February 20th, 2019, this year, when basically around the time when Tekashi pretty much came out. You know, that he pretty much turned his state. So, this video was like about 7 months ago. 7 months ago. Now, I want to see if y'all think this still apply to what's going on right now. I said this February 20th. Now, listen to this video, and I want to hear what y'all got to say in the comments. Y'all be easy.
It's your boy Frankie Hard Work with another video, and this video I want to talk about Tekashi 6ix9ine, and I was just sitting back thinking about something, and has Tekashi 6ix9ine single-handedly changed the way, not we, because I'm not part of that, the way young people look at snitching nowadays? And what made me think about that, because, you know, even some older people, to me, I feel like that. Because when you think about nowadays, when you look at some of these comments and some of these quotes people saying, and how people still receive this, how his music is still being played, how people pretty much saying that I would have did it too because pretty much they had sex with this girl, they said it was going to kill him and things of that nature. And also, when you hear some rappers' comments, like Casanova, either stating or pretty much he basically have no problem with him snitching. You know, that ain't got nothing to do with him. But he made a point, and this is what made me go into it. He made a point about saying gangster niggas, you know, our opinion, I ain't gonna call me a gangster, but pretty much niggas in the hood, opinion don't matter no more. And is that it? Is this the world we coming to right now? Because think about it. It was a valid point that he made. Think about it, right? Who's the one that's actually buying the records, right? Who's the one that's actually attending these concerts, right? Who's the one that's following him, right? Who the ones that pretty much, that ride with Tekashi and pretty much everything said that actually built his career? It was the young people. It was the young people that work. It was young people that's not all into hustling and selling drugs and doing that and into crimes and things of that nature. I ain't saying that was his whole fan base, but that was most of it. Understand? And we got to talk about some of the race, too. It was a lot of other people besides black people that liked Tekashi 6ix9ine. You understand? So a lot of these people that's all of a sudden saying, oh, well, snitching don't matter and this and that, we got to look at, because 9 times out of 10, they're not a person like me or some dude in the hood, no regular dude in the hood. That's not them. These are hardworking people mainly, kids, and people ain't about that life. So did he change the outlook on what people think snitching is now? Is he like making it okay? I mean, I don't believe it's okay. I believe if you get into this and this is what you do, then you gotta, you know what I mean? You gotta eat your plate like the rest, like everybody else. You gotta deal with it. This is what you decided to do, deal with it. Don't bring everybody else down because you can't take it. That's my outlook. But then you got these young people, Ryan, when you look at it, they don't even care about whether he's snitching or not. They still pumping his music. They can't wait till he come home. When he come home, they're going to be the first one to support him, right? It's not going to be niggas like me that's down here like, oh, Tekashi home, I'm supporting him. It's not going to be a nigga. It's going to be somebody way younger than him. You know what I'm saying? It's going to be somebody that's not even about this life, that never thought about this life, and that can possibly end up the same way he is. And that's hoping that, you know, people, what he's doing, he's actually making a lane for snitching now. When you think about it, he's making a lane for snitching now, because this wasn't cool a year ago. Before Tekashi 6ix9ine came, this was not cool. It was very, very frowned upon, and in the hood, you definitely get yourself hurt. But in the music, it would hurt your career. But it's been like being that he changed the outlook on it. You can even read the comments, and you can even tell the response that 6ix9ine and Academics got back when Academics dropped that song. A lot of people in the comments was like, I tell. If somebody was to lose to me, I tell. So, is this the world we living in now because of Tekashi 6ix9ine? know, it was just something I was thinking about because, you know, I'm just listening to everybody. I'm looking at some people's comments. I'm looking at some people's videos. And even at the times I stated on some you know, some YouTuber's page comments about he's a clown for snitching and, like, and get a bunch of replies where saying, oh, how do you feel like that? What makes you think your opinion such, such, such? And you can obviously see that the way some of these people respond, that they're not living the life I'm living, or I was living, rather. A lot of these people, clean cut, good, clean people with no records, doing none of that, they ain't about that life, but they like the gangster music, they in love with the gangster sound. But then when it comes to, when it's time to get down with the get down, they don't want no parts of that. So that was just something I was thinking about, like, have you changed the outlook on the way society think, the way young society think about snitching now? And even some of these older people too, I'm telling you. So my point about making my this is when you see this video, I just want you to think about what I'm saying and think about and read some of these comments and look at some people acting towards Tekashi as far as some snitching, how they're receiving it. Because I feel like a lot of people think this cool. If this was Bobby Shmurda that did that, that snitched like that, he wouldn't even get that. I'm not going to go into other things that I really want to say. I'm not going to do it right now. But I'm going to definitely make another video about this. You understand? So that was just something I was just looking at, a little observation I thought about. And it's your boy, Frankie Yard World. I'll come to you with another video. Just stay tuned. I'll let your boy. My bad. Just doing a little something.